Ruins of Dubai, Ras Al-Khaimah, and Umm Al Quwain. The first archaeological site in Dubai is Al-Khaimah lies on the northwestern side from Deira in Dubai Emirate. It is located in a swampland surrounded by sand dunes. Many tombs were found in Al-Khaimah site dating back to the 2000 BC. So the period in which to which Al-Khaimah site belongs to is 2000 BC, and it is in Dubai Emirate. This is the Al-Khaimah archaeological site where you can find the remnants of the burial grounds which were used by the people in the past. You can notice that the burial grounds where the burial chambers were not over the ground, like what we have seen with the beehive cemeteries and all. This is different. This is dug underground. This is not over the ground cemeteries. This is underground cemeteries. Next, the first archaeological site in Ras Al-Khaimah is Shamil. Shamil is actually a place that lies in the north of Ras Al-Khaimah city. A settlement traced back to the Iron Age was located there. Remnants of Shamil's site dates back to 2000 BC again, like Al-Khaimah's site. The archaeological findings such as industrial materials and cemetery buildings found in the Shamil site indicate a deep cultural relation between Shamil site and other settlements in the region for setting up external relations with them. The Shamil site comprises a number of proto-historic settlement remains, a very extensive cemetery, and a medieval fortress locally known as the Palace of the Queen of Sheba. This Palace of the Queen of Sheba, no such palace actually exists there right now, and the history beyond the same is under debate. Nobody has got a clear information of what it was or who was Sheba, who was the Queen of Sheba. Nobody has any clear information of the same. Whatever I could find regarding this Palace of Queen of Sheba, I'm adding as a link in the description. You can refer to that for your extended learning. And this area has been settled for at least 4,500 years. It was found, and its former inhabitants have benefited from its favorable setting close to the sea. You know that already Ras Al-Khaimah is a coastal region. So this Shamil site also being near to the sea, they were having a good land over there. Pastures were there, the land was cultivable, they did agriculture and farming, fishing, animal husbandry, hunting, and horticulture were their main subsistence through the ages. That is how they survived, they earned their living. But also, along with all this, far distance trade with Mesopotamia, Bahrain, Iran, and the Indian subcontinent was certainly important. Leftovers or traces of trade was also found in Shamil site. These are the remnants of the Shamil site in Ras Al-Khaimah. Nothing much is found. Now moving on to Umm Al Quwain, the first archaeological site in Umm Al Quwain Emirates. Tell Abrak. Now, Tell Abrak, if you can Google Tell Abrak, you will understand that it lies at the demarcation line here between Sharjah and Umm Al Quwain. It lies in the demarcation line here between Sharjah and Umm Al Quwain Emirates. It rises 10 meters above the surrounding plain, that is, it's a hilly kind of region. And it is considered an important settlement with settlers from 3000 BC. Notice the difference. The other Shamil and Khaimah site, they belong to 2000 BC, whereas Tell Abrak, the first archaeological site in Umm Al Quwain Emirate, belonged to 3000 BC. The settlers belong to 3000 BC, and it also has traces of a group of buildings dating back to the Iron Age. Now, Tell Abrak mainly consists of houses made of palm leaves. you know, it was a deserted place, so you can imagine how or why they were using palm leaves, because that is easily available to them. And those houses were surrounded by a huge mud fort of diameter 40 meters with a stone front. And it is also noticed that it is the largest among the towers, and the same kind of Umm civilization, the same kind of towers or the houses were also found in Umm civilization. This is a Telebrak archaeological site. Now, if you read more about Telebrak, you will get to know that Telebrak boasts the largest collection of faunal remains. Now, what do you mean by faunal remains? It means the items left behind when an animal dies, like its bones, shells, horns, etc. So, many faunal remains were uncovered on the archaeological site of the Telebrak than any other within the Arabian Peninsula. Animals such as sheep, goats, cattle were reared, while locally available wild animals such as gazelle and oryx were hunted by the people over there. Now, since they were coastal, in the coastal region, they got fishes, then shellfish, and as well as turtles from the Persian Gulf. They were eaten extensively. That was found by archaeologists. And while these archaeologists were digging the site, and they could uncover almost 1 lakh animal bone remains. There is also evidence of extensive trade links between the people of Telebrak and Mesopotamia, Iran, and the Indus Valley. Now, children, I hope you are familiar with the word Mesopotamia. If not, I'll tell you what. Mesopotamia is actually today's Iraq, which you're more familiar with, right? Now, in Greek, the word Mesopotamia means between two rivers, okay? So, the civilization of ancient Mesopotamia grew up along the banks of two great rivers, which are the Euphrates and Tigris, okay? You know, it's a desert, and in the midst of that big desert, the people of Mesopotamia relied upon these rivers to provide drinking water for their agricultural irrigation and major transportation routes. Okay, these two rivers, Euphrates and Tigris, provided everything for the people of the present-day Iraq. But now what has happened is a tragedy actually. These two rivers still exist and they are flowing to some extent. But the water of those rivers have become so much contaminated. Contaminated to a level that it cannot be used by people. It is not drinkable at all. Okay, those who are drinking, or every time Iraq, many people are dying consuming this unsafe water. Many people die out of thirst, and many are dying out of illness which they got by drinking this unsafe water. So all this is happening in Iraq now. The one article which I got about the same, I'm adding in the description box. You can read that also. Now, what led to the conclusion that these Telebrak people were having their trade with the Indus Valley civilization, Mesopotamia and all, is because of the findings there that the archaeologists found. They could find a few Harappan cubical weights, distinctive Harappan carnelian and agate jewelry, and tin and ivory from Afghanistan. All these remains were found from the Telebrak site. Now, you might be thinking, what is this cubical weight? Carnelian, agate, all those things. I'll get you some pictures for that. This is the Harappan cubical weight system. This is how they used to weigh things. These are the measurement weights. Okay. And this is the carnelian and the agate stones used for making jewelry. So I hope the topic is clear to you. So in this chapter, we are just learning about the first archaeological sites in Dubai, Ras Al-Khaimah and Umm Al Quwain Emirates, Al-Qisis, Shamal and Telebrak respectively. Okay, so I hope that is clear to you. Let me know if you have any further doubts on this topic. Just post it in the comment section below and try to answer the exercises given at the back of the text. Here I have added the one task which you have in the textbook. I have added here. You can check with this also. So I hope that's clear to you. That's it. Thank you.